This is our biggest show yet.
Quick, quick, quick. How you feeling?
Like I'm about to burst.
Just a little antsy, a little nervous.
To get here has been very challenging.
We don't have a risk assessment for that.
Just enjoy and just bounce back from anything that might go slightly awry.
We're risking everything.
Oh my God.
Three deep breaths to cleanse the aura.
Take it off.
Bring in more and let it out with a hug. Oh.
Old Asian lady,
too.
I need this to go well because it means the world to me.
Are you ready?
Yeah! I'm Shane.
Looking back, it makes me a bit sad to think about how much effort I put into trying not to be feminine. I can remember being quite heartbroken that I didn't get cast as the prince in this production of Cinderella. And then one of the other boys told me, "Of course you didn't, you're so girly." And everyone laughed. And so even though I loved theater and I loved performing when I was a kid, I saw that career as completely unviable for me.
It wasn't until I came to London and I discovered drag beyond just men dressed as women. When I saw trans people doing drag, I saw non-binary and queer people doing drag and just really expressing themselves in whatever way felt authentic. I think that everyone could learn something from doing drag, trying it out. If you put on a heel or a dress or a bit of lipstick, an eyelash, maybe all of them, and you see how you feel. Do you like it? Do you hate it? And just kind of sit with those feelings. Ask yourself some questions, because that's what I originally did, and it helped me discover who I am. It totally changed my life. It may have even saved it.
Life for a femme, Asian, non-binary trans person is risky from the moment I walk out my front door. And to be on stage and be visible, that's even riskier. I'm willing to take that risk because I don't want to hide trying to exist in the shadows.
When I tell people that I am a drag queen, they're very surprised. As an AFAB person, which means assigned female at birth, drag is already quite hard to do. And then I've got the barriers of being a queer, Asian curvy woman. I've been in this industry for nearly 10 years, and I'm still having to prove that I can do everything just as well, just as good, having to constantly prove myself all the time. And it gets frustrating. But if this is what I want to do, I'm going to do it. And I'll break through all your freaking walls, every single one. If that means that gives the next curvy Asian queer person an easier path to get through, to be able to do what they're meant to be doing, then I'll do it.
I've often found in the cabaret community that they want me on their lineup because they want it to look diverse. They don't actually want me as a person, they just want the idea of what a Japanese person is. So if I ever came across another Asian in the cabaret scene, I was like, I need to know you. We should have each other's back. We should make our own platforms. We should tell our own stories. And that's kind of what led to starting the Bitten Peach.
So it's 5, 6, 7, 8. Right, left, out.
The Bitten Peach is the UK's only gender-diverse, pan-Asian drag and cabaret collective. The founders, which are me, Lily and Evelyn, are very excited about doing our biggest show ever, but simultaneously a bit stressed and a little nervous because there is a lot of pressure that we do something big. And so we've made a show about what it means to be both queer and Asian. I get a chance to show the world that my story and my identity matter.
I hope we have, like, hundreds of tickets sold.
Hope for the best, all the best. Don't stress, do your best.
So I'm actually gonna tie it like higher and tighter.
Like,
and then I've rhinestoned some underwear.
Show them the panties.
Yeah, yeah, okay. Extra, oh, there we go. And then, wah! Is that Asian enough for you?
Yeah.
As a mixed race Asian, I had a lot of internal racism. I was still raised with an idea and a mentality that white is right. And that's really hurtful when I think about it now. But I was very lucky to meet a group of people who allowed me to accept me as I am as a whole. I'm okay. I'm like, I just get super emotional when I talk about it because you guys are all fucking awesome. Thank you. Sorry.
Even like running into people out in the world, I often feel like time to turn on. Like, here's a little show. I'm not gonna tell them that actually I'm really stressed and actually I'm going through this and that. It's like, rah, 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 looking fun, feeling fabulous. And they don't necessarily want to know the deeper layers. After my grandpa passed away, we had to go through all his stuff. In the garden shed, on the back shelf in the corner, there was a really old suitcase, and inside were all of these beautiful, colorful kimonos, which were so stunning but so surprising to find because even though my family is Japanese, we don't wear kimonos, we don't speak Japanese, we're not really participants in the culture, so I wondered where these had come from. It turns out the suitcase they were hidden in still had my grandma's Japanese name and her internment camp registration number on it, because that was the one suitcase that she was allowed to bring when her and her family had to live in the Japanese internment camps in the middle of the desert for all of World War II. To find this piece of her history, where she'd literally put her culture away, really resonated with me as a queer person, thinking about all the pieces of our identity we have to package away and put away in the farthest part of your mind just to be able to survive. It inspired me to rebuild a connection to being queer, being Asian, and how they kind of overlap. I know from stories that my grandma felt there were doors closed to her purely because she was Japanese. So I think seeing me break through some of those doors, she'd be so excited. I think she'd be there knocking these doors with me.
Through this show, I want to make sure that we're able to show off why Asians deserve to be on stages this big.
When you come off stage after that, you won't be able to go backstage because that door can't open.
So oh no.
Yeah, so we'll exit down the stairs.
That's vital information.
Because that's
just general exit anyway.
That's just
gold
general
dress
exit.
Is actually super difficult to put on.
Behind all the makeup and the hair and the costumes, it's actually quite a scary place to be in, to be that vulnerable and share your story on stage. I've experienced quite a bit of racism and transphobia, and even though those are the things that make my existence scary, I think those are the reasons why it's so important that my story gets told.
Should we bite the peach on three?
What's a rare peach?
Okay, we're all gonna bite the peach.
By the power of the bitten peach.
Okay. And we have to make a biting sound, a chomping sound.
Okay.
One, two, three. Now, has anyone seen my body crystals?
The bitten peach.
And the people that see ShayShay just coming on stage unapologetically, being their authentic selves, that's enough for someone to go, maybe I could do that. I can be me. You know, everyone around is loving this. Like, this is real. This is what life should be like everywhere.
ShayShay has actually really taught me to be vulnerable and to be genuine to myself. And they inspire me to not be afraid to speak out.
Girls who look like me are supposed to cry over boys who look like him. I'd seen all the movies and read all the books. We were just following the plot.
It's so lovely when people come up to you and tell you they were just happy to see someone else of their body type or their skin tone on stage doing something that's not a stereotypical thing.
The chained lady wanted to celebrate her newly found freedom.
I discovered how multi-layered drag is, that it can be political, angry, fierce, protest. It can be fun, messy, trashy, colorful. And all those things can happen at once, which is just like what it's like being a human.
Yes, my Asians! We see you, we fucking love you!
To see that there's all these queer Asians in the same room together, isn't that so rare to observe this queer Asian joy? Isn't this what paradise looks like?
Oh, it was amazing.
Can I get a picture of you, Shay?
Of course. Hey, Mom, get the pic.
I know that some queer Asians don't get to be their authentic self outside of these spaces. So what an amazing thing to be able to offer to them and offer to myself. My grandma was definitely a fan of glamour, so I think the fact that a lot of my job has to do with looking glamorous, I think she'd be very much into that. I wonder what she'd think if she knew that I was wearing some of her items when I go on stage. I hope she'd be like, yeah.